afternoon. I practiced saying good afternoon so I wouldn't say good morning. Right? Good afternoon. Welcome to St. John's United Church of Christ on this very special occasion. I'm Reverend Todd Hackman. I am a pastor at St. John's United Church of Christ. There for a little while I was the pastor at St. John's United Church of Christ. And I am so happy to say that I am not a pastor. And today we get to celebrate this occasion of Pastor Christina's ministry with us here at St. John's and officially install her as an associate pastor of engagement for St. John's United Church of Christ. So we're glad you're here. Be sure to stick around after our worship service today. There is a potluck that will be served downstairs in the fellowship hall. We hope everyone can stick around and enjoy some good fellowship and some good food. And I did scout out there's plenty of food there for everyone. So please join us after worship. This is a culmination of a long process. Our good folks, the good work of our search team that brought us to this occasion, many of them who are participating in the service today, so much gratitude to them. And thank you for the clergy who are joining us, and particularly Reverend Dr. Sandra Grant, who will bring in the message for us today. We appreciate your presence and look forward to the message. So welcome, and let us begin.
Good afternoon. As a way to engage the congregation and as a way to envision the future of the church, please take one of those strips of paper and on it write a hope or a vision that you have for St. John's. Think about what inspires you or what you would like to see go on and happen in our church. Pastor Christina will use these strips in her prayers, and the paper chain will be displayed as a visual for the congregation. The paper strips will be collected during the offering, or there are baskets near the doors of the sanctuary. There will also be paper strips available downstairs in Fellowship Hall.
Good afternoon. Joining in the call to worship. Hallelujah, we rejoice.
We rejoice with gladness and excitement.
We are gathered here to worship God, who calls us to be a community in ministry, mission, faith, and in the Church of Jesus Christ, the head of the church.
Let us worship with grateful hearts, for God, sure and steadfast love, has brought us to this awaited day.
Let us worship in the spirit of the living Christ, who gives us vision and hope to persevere and to abide in love.
Let us worship that we might be strengthened to bring forth a just world for all.
In the name of the Creator, Christ, and Spirit One, Amen.
Thank you. please join me in the prayer of invocation? God of many, we rejoice in the life you give us. You have raised our hopes and instilled in us the courage to dream, to dare, and to do great things with your love. We rejoice in the gift of this church. Today, we know and recognize that we are surrounded by the saints who have endured hardships and celebrated in joy for the sake of the gospel. As we come together as a church and faith community, we are in the presence of friends in Christ who share this incredible journey with us. Today is a new day for St. John's United Church of Christ. We ask that you fill this worship space with your light and strength, with your power and peace. We pray this with the Spirit of Jesus Christ. Amen. You may be seated.
And individually, we are members of the grace given to us, prophecy in proportion to faith, ministry in ministering, the teacher in teaching, the exhorter in exhortation, the giver in generosity, the leader in diligence, the compassionate in cheerfulness. Let love be genuine, hate what is evil, hold fast to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Outdo one another in showing honor. Do not lag in zeal. Be ardent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Be patient in suffering. Persevere in prayer. Contribute to the needs of the saints. Extend hospitality to strangers. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do. Live in harmony with one another. Do not be haughty, but associate with the lowly. Do not claim to be wiser than you are. Do not repay anyone evil for evil, but take thought for what is noble in the sight of all. If it is possible, so far as it depends on you, live peaceably, for it is written, "Vengeance is mine. I will repay," says the Lord. No, if anything this, you will heap burning coals on their heads. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good.
Christina, and all of you in this community of St. John's for this time of real union between and among you all. That you have the vision and courage to call a minister, a leader of engagements, and that Christina, in taking on this challenge to lead you in your engagement endeavors, is quite a wonderful thing. Points to her leadership and all of her leadership abilities in this endeavor. I know her to be fearless, compassionate, creative, and hopeful, and very engaging. While Minister of Engagement is Christina's call, acting with a ministry of engagement is the call of everyone sitting here. In getting ready for today, I pondered how to best talk about ideas of engagement. First, I thought about Mary Oliver, who talks about living your one wild and precious life, and what will you do in your one wild and precious life? Today, about living your one wild and precious life as a congregation, and I've been thinking of ways that I might be able to offer some ideas or some light on the idea of engagement itself. I know I'm not alone in this. I saw that you really thought about what it meant to be engaged as you called Christina to your congregation. A section of Paul's letter, a testament of true engagement, and had that help me guide me in my thinking. So did a few other things. During this time, I had one of those lovely notices from one of my great nieces and nephew-to-be. It was one of those save-the-date notices. She was showing off her beautiful engagement ring, and they were both beaming with joy and pride, and of course, mutual affection, unaware of all the world would challenge them with in their future together. They start on a ride of a lifetime. Engagements. Then I turned on my TV to see an old rerun of a study. Engage the thruster, Scotty! And Scotty shouting back, "I'm doing the best I can." It's like this. And then I read that wonderful poem from Mary Oliver, that wonderful poet. What do you plan to do with your one wild and precious life? A question for each of us, really, but also a question for all of us together. Engage. Several weeks ago, Christina shared with me the results of your congregational survey, which led you to call her as Minister of Engagement. Your careful review of your needs, the trends of other churches, and the challenges that congregations are facing everywhere are nothing less than impressive. It's clear that you have worked diligently to find a match. Christina also, during this time, was working very diligently. A seasoned professional, she was engaged in a years-long discernment process to go from her 20-year teaching career to be a minister of engagements. You at St. John's have your ideas for engagement, I'm sure, and so does Christina. And so, it seems, does the Apostle Paul. Did you hear what he said about engagements? Talking to a bearing amongst themselves over things people tend to argue about, whose ideas are best, who knows more, who's the most moral, the most holy, the most prestigious, the most giving, the most, ad nauseam. And Paul, experienced but fairly new to the whole following Christ endeavor himself, writes a letter to this church, exhorting them to be people of engagements, to engage the Spirit above all things. And incredibly, this engagement of the Spirit comes down to doing some very practical things. Practical, but not easy. I'd like you to hear Paul's words and see how they pair with the engagement that you and your congregation are contemplating, and how you will ask Christina to lead you in that process, in that endeavor. So, here's what Paul has to say. First of all, we are all parts of one body. In a world where everything is about differentiation and status, this is frankly a radical idea to embrace. We don't do it alone. It's a congregation. There is not one person here who would bring your congregation to the place you want it to be together. We are parts of one body. It takes a team. And it takes, Paul said, mutual affection. Imagine that. And I add, mutual accountability. What Christina brings to you is 20-some odd years of engaging both youth and adults through very complex circumstances. What you bring are many years of engaging with each other in this congregation and all the different and particular gifts that you have to offer. Offered for the sake of renewing faith and building a church. She offers the wisdom of discernment. You offer the readiness to map out this next part of the journey. So, again, here's what Paul has to say. First of all, parts of one body. And then, it may ponder a bit about how often in churches we tend to create hierarchies, both big and small. We do it in our national United Church of Christ. Somehow, we have this kind of need to be sure everyone knows their place. But here's the thing. Paul says, everyone has a place. He reminds us that churches are not places for pushing our power around, for making sure that our agenda is the agenda that gets met, but rather a place where everyone in the circle is valued for the gifts that they bring. Partners in service. Caring, sharing with each other. Partners where each one offers something important. Each one offers something important. Here are some of the examples Paul offers to us over the span of generations. First, he talks about the gift of prophecy, the gift of vision that can see the direction of faith, that can see events happening with the eyes of faith. Who here is doing that? The gift of ministry. Aha, you don't just have a couple of ministers here. You are all ministers. It's a gift that's potentially shared by every single one of us. The gift of teaching. I probably can't say enough how important this gift is in a world where education has become so devalued, in a world that longs and hungers for more knowledge and the ability to reflect and discern and be proactive about issues that are so critical in our world. The gift of teaching. The gift of speaking out. Sometimes I don't know when not to speak out. But I do value this as an important gift, even when it gets you in a little trouble. The gift of speaking out, particularly for what is just and good and loving, what contains mutual affection and care. And also, I might add, because I've learned this through my years of experience, the gift of knowing when to speak out and when to listen. The gift of being a giver, Paul said that, and then said, and to give, that ability to give with a generous heart. So here we are, Thanksgiving week. Thanksgiving. We give as a result of our thankfulness, and we give generously, not wanting to know exactly where the gift will go all the time, but giving generously and hopefully. The gift of leading, and the care and diligence that real leadership calls for. You're called leaders to lead you, but there are also ways that each of you may find yourselves leading. So, as a congregation, in your ministry of engagement, can you take a little bit of time to name, at least in your hearts, the people who you know have these gifts? How are they using the gifts? Think of people that you know. Think of people that you've worked with. And while you're talking about gifts, can you see yourself in any of the gifts that Paul talks about? For instance, who here encourages mutual affection among your membership? Are there any people who know how to resolve conflicts, who get right in the middle and help each other to hear each other? Mutual affection. Who reminds everyone by their example that living as an honorable human being is an honor we all must take on? Who keeps faith alive here? Who are the servants to the congregation? Who are the servants to the community? Is that you? Who are the servants to the needs of the world? Is that you? Which ones of you are the ones who create hope, even when others insist that things are hopeless? Which ones of you can be seen giving hospitality to the stranger, to the visible ones in poverty, and to the invisible ones in poverty? To the immigrants, to the different one, to the one who has ideas very different from your own. Among you can say that they sit patiently with those who weep and grieve? And how long are you able to stay with that grief? Which ones of you have been able to forgive little petty things, or big terrible things? For vengeance belongs to God, and to God alone. Not any of us. I just want to add here, I think that's one of those misunderstood phrases from Paul's letter, that people think that when Paul said, vengeance is mine, says the Lord, that he meant, that's mine, vengeance is mine, says the Lord. No, 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 no. The idea was that vengeance belongs to God, not us. All of these things, this is the engagement that Paul calls us to. And certainly none of us can engage in those gifts alone. We need you read more about Paul, he wasn't just speaking on a local congregational level. He was speaking interpersonally, but that's what we should be doing with each other. But he was also speaking to a nation. And he was also speaking to a multi-faith, multi-religious world. We're not in such a different place today. Paul speaks to you, to us, as a congregation, as a nation, as people in a multiply complex, multi-religious world. And there are challenges. And we know the challenges may be better than the solutions. And that's why we need each other. So if you can imagine three circles, one nested within the other, there is the engagement that we have here. But around us, engagement is needed. With people we don't even see, with people we don't even know. And then in the world, another circle, with people we don't even know, but people with whom we breathe, people with whom we stand up, people with whom we cherish God's love, God's land, God's people. All people. So, today you're writing on those pieces of paper. I love that. You're writing on ways that you as a congregation will engage. And I think by doing that and all the other kinds of things that you will be doing like that, you will be working toward creating these wonderful, hospitable spaces for people to be and for people to engage the faith. By doing that, we invite room for mutual conversation to occur. I hope that you have many mutual conversations, and I hope they come with mutual affection, with forgiveness, with hope, with grace. We open our hearts to listen, to forgive, to enable everyone's gifts, and to emerge acting new possibilities. And we're invited to do this in every circle, in every sphere of life. This is communion. This is living the faith that Paul calls us to. Now, of course, you know, I know that you know this, that Christina won't do all the engaging for you. That would be nice, wouldn't it? Hire Christina and have her do the engaging. You don't have to worry about any of this. But Christina will work beside you. And she'll help you to develop the hospitable spaces as you join in partners in service to minister within and beyond your own walls. For you are one body with many members and with gifts that you haven't yet unwrapped. Listen with care to each other. Reach out with generosity to the community. Offer alternatives to vengeance, which was never anyone's to begin with. Bring love to a world divided, love to nations weeping, love to wanderers seeking, peace to those torn apart by hate, peace to nations ripped apart by violence, peace to a world groaning for justice and for joy. Engage the spirit of the holy. Make this your one wild and precious task. Join hand in hand with mutual affection, and may God bless all of your endeavors. Amen.
Thank you. meant that in word, prayer, and song. It is now time for offerings of gifts to God. This evening's offering will be received for the Wisconsin Conference UCC Seminary and Fund, which provides resources and scholarships for those on a path towards ordination. Conference scholarships, along with financial aid from seminary and students' personal funds, provide crucial support to financing the theological education and preparation of persons who will serve in ministry. In any given year, there are approximately 30 to 40 members in discernment in our conference. Your gifts will help not only the members in discernment, but also help in all places they will minister throughout their lives in ministry. So I invite you to give generously. Through you, the Wisconsin Conference changes lives and is vibrant. At this time, if you have not written out a hope for the church on the strip of paper to be placed in the offering plate, you can do that now too. So let us now receive our offering.
Join me in the prayer of dedication. Fount of every blessing, receive these gifts with the joy in which you give them. Bless these gifts to your church universal. May they be used to fill in the gaps of what we cannot yet imagine. May we always take joy in being blessed to give and to share with you and each other. Amen.
Association of the Wisconsin Conference of the United Church of Christ greets you in the name of Jesus Christ, the head of the church in heaven and on earth. Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, Let us also lay aside every weight and sin which clings so closely. Let us run with perseverance the race that is set before us.
Let us look to Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy of his faith endured the cross, despised his shame, and is seated at the right hand of the throne of God.
St. John's United Church of Christ, under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, has called Reverend Christina Schoenwetter as pastor and teacher, and respectfully requests that the Southwest Association install her in these ministries among us, according to the faith and order of the United Church of Christ.
The Southwest Association has reviewed the requests of St. John's United Church of Christ. We have carefully examined Christina, and we are pleased to install her as your pastor and teacher. Christina, servant of God, we invite you to come forward as a sign of your acceptance of the call to this office.
Installation is an action of the Association of the United Church of Christ in cooperation with the local church, the call setting, and the pastor. Installation confirms and celebrates the covenantal relationship among these partners. Installation is a sign that these covenantal partners are committed to share mutually in the mission of the United Church of Christ and of the Ecumenical Church. Hear these words from the Apostle Paul. We beg you, our brothers and sisters and siblings, to pay proper respect to those who work among you, who guide and instruct you in the Christian life. Treat them with the greatest respect and love because of the work they do. Be at peace among yourselves.
We urge you, our sister, warn the idle, encourage the timid, help the weak, be patient with all.
See that no one pays back wrong for wrong, but at all times, make it your aim to do good to one another and to all people. Be joyful always. Pray at all times. Be thankful in all circumstances. This is what God wants for you in your life in Jesus Christ. Amen.
Dear friends, St. John's United Church of Christ has declared that, having gathered under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, it has called Reverend Christina Schoenwetter to minister in this place as pastor and teacher, and that it now receives her as appointed by God for this ministry. The Southwest Association of the United Church of Christ has declared that she has met all the necessary conditions for installation to this office. Christina, seeing that you are called to ordain ministry by the grace of God, and that it is St. John's, and that St. John's UCC has been led to call you as pastor and teacher, are you willing to enter into this covenant with its members, who are one in Christ with us in the Southwest Association?
I am willing, as I promise to serve faithfully, fulfilling the ministries of the pastoral office, according to the faith and order of the United Church of Christ.
Members of St. John's United Church of Christ, will those who are able rise and affirm your covenant with Christina?
We, the members of the Southwest Association of the United Church of Christ, gather with you, Reverend Christina Schoenwetter, and with your call session, St. John's United Church of Christ, as a sign of our covenant and celebration of our mutual ministry in Christ's name.
Will the members of the Southwest Association please rise in body or spirit and affirm your covenant with Reverend Christina Schoenwetter and St. John's United Church of Christ? And we're going to read that same thing again because we want our partners in the association to also covenant together with us. We, the members of the Southwest Association of the United Church of Christ, gather with you, Reverend Christina Schoenwetter, and with your call session, St. John's United Church of Christ, as a sign of our covenant and in celebration of our mutual ministry in Christ's name. Thank you. You may be seated. Let us pray. Almighty God, You have called your servants to make promises before you. Now enable us to keep our vows, that we may remain steadfast in faith and fruitful in every good work. Bless, we pray, your servant, Reverend Christina Schoenwetter, to whom the care of your people in this church is now committed. Pour out your Holy Spirit on her ministries and on those with whom she serves, and on all the churches of the Southwest Association, that our mutual ministry may be served with all faithfulness, diligence, and courage. Grant us the spirit of power and of love and of a sound mind. Make our ministry a means of awakening the careless, strengthening the faithful, comforting the afflicted, building up your church, and converting sinners to you. Guard us against the snare of temptation, that we may be kept pure in heart, fervent in spirit, and valiant against all evil. And at the last, by your grace, receive us into your eternal home, where with you and the Holy Spirit, Christ reigns in glory, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. Now I get to do the part. In the name of Jesus Christ, and on behalf of the Southwest Association of the Wisconsin Conference of the United Church of Christ, my dear sir, I declare you duly installed as pastor and teacher of St. John's United Church of Christ. Thanks be to God.
Pastor Christina, ending with the prayer that Jesus taught us. Eternal God, we pray you hear the vows we have made today. May our promises to one another and your creation be steadfast and true. Give us the grace to do the work to which you have called us in Christ Jesus. Fill this community at St. John's United Church of Christ with your Spirit, that it may work together as one body, as one people, to be the body of Christ in his reconciling ministry. Blend together the variety of gifts manifested within this congregation to strengthen its fellowship for service to the world. In ministry partnership with Pastor Christina, we pray that your will may be done here on earth through our worship, witness, and work. We ask this in the spirit of Jesus Christ, the one who taught us to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Okay, so I'm going to share a prayer with you, and the prayer was written by John O'Donohue, and it's just a really, really great prayer. So as you listen to this poem, consider it a blessing for the covenant we have established as we have been called an associate pastor of engagement. As we embark on this new journey together, may we all recognize the new position and the possibility of the work for the church. May your new work excite your heart, kindle it in your mind creativity to journey beyond old limits of all that has become wearisome. May this work challenge you toward new frontiers that will emerge as you begin to approach them, calling forth from you the full force and the depth of your undiscovered gifts. May the work fit the rhythms of your soul, enabling you to draw from the invisible new ideas and a vision that will inspire. Remember to be kind to those who work for you. Endeavor to remain aware of the quiet world that lives behind each face. Be fair in your expectations, compassionate in your criticism. May you have the grace of encouragement to awaken the gift of the other's heart, building in them the confidence to follow the call of the gift. May you come to know that work which emerges from the mind of love will have beauty and form. May this new work be worthy of the energy of your heart and the light of your thought. May your work assume a proper space in your life. Instead of owning or using you, may it challenge and refine you, bringing you every day further into the wonder of your heart.
Thank you.
after the benediction, I invite the congregation to be seated for the last song and the clergy to stick around for a photo. As we enter into covenant with each other, may we embrace unity as diverse members of one body, using our unique gifts for the common good. Let love be genuine, hatred be disfavored, and kindness be our constant guide. May we overcome evil with good, bless those who persecute us, and live in harmony, radiating the light of Christ in all we do. Go in peace. Amen.